Utah Jazz legend Mark Eaton has died at the age of 64. His body was discovered near his bicycle in Summit County. We have team coverage of this tonight with Fox 13's Morgan Vance looking back at the All-Star's career. But first we go to Diego Romo, who has more about the moments before his untimely death.
According to a Summit County Sheriff's Office press release, Eaton was found here on Long Rifle Road in the Silver Creek Estates just outside of Park City. The Sheriff's Office received a call just before 8:30 Friday night from a nearby resident who found a man lying unconscious in the road next to his bicycle. Shortly after, the man was identified as 64-year-old Summit County resident and former Jazz All-Star Mark Eaton. The press release says Eaton was quickly transported to a nearby hospital where he later died. The Sheriff's Office issued a statement saying, quote, "The Summit County Sheriff's Office offers our sincere condolences to the Eaton family, the Utah Jazz family, and friends of Mark." Gail Miller and the Miller family saying, quote, "We are deeply saddened to learn of the unexpected passing of our dear friend and basketball great, Mark Eaton. One of the most imposing defensive players in NBA history, he was a giant of a man in more than just stature. Mark was a pillar of our community who adopted Utah as his home and was deeply committed to the Utah Jazz. Our family treasures the times we shared with him and send our deepest sympathies to his loved ones." The Summit County Sheriff's Office says there were no witnesses and there is no reason to believe he was struck by a car while riding his bike. The Utah Office of the Medical Examiner will now take over the investigation into the cause of his death. In Summit County, Diego Romo, Fox 13 News, Utah.
Thank you, Diego. Now joining us in studio, Morgan Vance, with a look back at the big man's impact on the state of Utah and, of course, the game of basketball. Morgan, quite the career both on and off of the court.
Yeah, terribly shocking news for not only fans of Jazz basketball, but anybody who knew Eaton through his various community involvement and business endeavors. Mark was a giant of a man, not only physically, but in terms of his character and love for the state of Utah, a stint that goes all the way back to the 1982 NBA draft, where Utah selected the 7'4" center out of UCLA, 72nd overall in the fourth round. Of course, nobody knew at the time what Eaton would amount to. He would end up joining forces with the likes of John Stockton and Karl Malone to put the Jazz on everyone's radar as an up-and-coming team. Eaton would retire long before Utah ever got to the NBA Finals, but not before establishing himself as a defensive juggernaut throughout the 80s. He led the league in blocks four different times and earned Defensive Player of the Year honors in both 85 and 89. He did make the All-Star team once as well. Reaction is slow as people take time to grieve, but Charles Barkley did say this during today's TNT broadcast.
"I have been texting with Mark Eaton every day this week. We have a mutual friend, Cowboy Joe West, who just broke the record for the most games umpired. He sent me this picture Thursday night with the guy on the left is Paul Krause.
Who played with the Minnesota Vikings for a long time.
And obviously, you know, the great Jim McMahon. He sends me this picture Thursday. He sends me pictures every day this week. They had a big celebration. Man, what, because he said, hey, you know this guy? I said, that's the great Joey Crawford right there. And when I got into the studio this morning, they said, Ben told me that Mark had passed away, and it just broke my heart.
Man, it's just a
big loss for our family.
That's just a stunner. When you know these guys personally, when you know what a good, just a good person, man, Mark Eaton was.
Yeah, an interesting coincidence right there. I'm sure more tributes will pour in soon. The Jazz did release this statement today. I'll read the end of it. His presence continued around the organization as a friend and ambassador, while giving back as a businessman and volunteer to his adopted hometown in Utah. We extend our deepest condolences to his wife, Terry, and their extended family. Mark will be greatly missed by all of us with the Jazz. I had the honor of chatting with Mark on a couple different occasions over the years. It was a little hard on the neck holding a conversation having to tilt so far up, but make no mistake, he was as classy as they come, and couple that with the Sean Bradley tragedy not long ago, just another tough pill to swallow, Brian.